He's said to have survived a train crash, narrowly escaped a plane crash, and survived multiple fiery car crashes. Chuck Norris once asked for his autograph, and he refused. His fortune cookies simply read, "Congratulations." He's the luckiest unlucky man in the world. Stick around to find out more.
I'm not listening to you, you're crazy.
If you've grown up watching action movies, you'll know that ridiculous and impossible special effects are just par for the course. That's the way things work on the big screen. For Frane Selak, though, the truth may be stranger and more dramatic than anything Hollywood could cook up. But what really is the truth? This humble man was born in Croatia in 1929. He led a relatively unremarkable life as a music teacher, which is hardly the most high-octane, daredevil occupation out there, until a fateful train journey in 1962 set off an unbelievable, impossible chain of events. While riding the rails from Sarajevo to Dubrovnik, a freak accident saw his train catapult into a river. 17 passengers were killed, Selak reports, but he was able to swim to shore with nothing but a broken arm and hypothermia for his troubles. This harrowing event was just the beginning of what lay in store for him down the line. The very next year, Frane was flying from Zagreb to Rijeka. He reports that an accident saw a door come detached from the aircraft, which caused it to crash. This time, 19 people lost their lives, while the superhuman Selak was reportedly found in a haystack. He awoke in a hospital, appropriately rattled, but really none the worse for wear. Next, on the list of modes of transport that clearly think that Frane Selak did them a great personal wrong, we have the bus. In 1966, the unfortunate man was in another fatal accident when the bus he was riding again plunged into a river. There were 4 casualties, but again, he came out largely unscathed. A couple of comparatively uneventful years passed until 1970. When Selak reports that his car's fuel tank exploded on the motorway, he just barely escaped with his seemingly charmed life. 1973 saw another freak car incident, when a malfunctioning fuel pump leaked petrol over his vehicle and sent flames spewing at him. Fast forward a couple of decades to 1995, and he's making news again as a Zagreb bus knocked him down. The next year came the immortal man's 7th and final famous disaster. A truck came barreling towards his Skoda as he drove around a mountain road. This episode ended with Selak leaping free, only to watch in horror as the vehicle exploded. So, there it is. Is Selak the unluckiest man in human history to have had all these disasters befall him? Or is he actually the luckiest for having survived them? That depends. Is your glass half empty or half full? It's important to remember that some have doubts about these 7 separate claims. Selak himself certainly made sure to emphasize the drama of his life story and plays up the effect these incidents had on him. "There came a stage when I was lucky to have any friends at all," he once said. "Many stopped seeing me, saying I was bad karma." But where does the line between impossible fact and fiction start to blur? It's true that there's a lack of official verification of some of these incidents. The 1962 train crash, and the 1963 plane crash, for instance. And some inconsistencies in the accounts. Whether this is due to failing memories, embellishments, tall stories, or something else, we may never know the whole truth of this man's extraordinary life. One thing's for certain, though. There was one more amazing piece to add to this man's life puzzle. One nobody can deny. In the mid-2000s, as though to make up for the horrible deal Lady Luck had given him, Selak won the lottery in Croatia. His jackpot was worth around £600,000. With this, he bought a luxurious home, only to have a change of heart and sell it in 2010. He returned to a humble life with his 5th wife. "All I need at my age is my Katerina. Money would not change anything. When she arrived, I knew then that I really did have a charmed, blessed life." Whatever happened along the way, Frane's story has a happy ending. He spent the last of his winnings on a hip operation and on a shrine to the Virgin Mary in thanks for his good fortune. So what do you think? Was Frane Selak the luckiest man in the world or the unluckiest? Let us know what you think in the comments section and hit that subscribe button and notification bell. You'll be glad you did. Until next time, I'm Rick James, asking you to keep it crazy.